लेक्चर वीडियो सीरीज रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस मॉड्यूल टू सोलार थर्मल एनर्जी कलेक्टर। हियर इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दी पैराबोलिक डिश स्टिरलिंग इंजन सिस्टम, वर्किंग ऑफ स्टिरलिंग और ब्रेटन हीट इंजन सिस्टम, सोलार कलेक्टर सिस्टम इन टू बिल्डिंग सर्विसेस। सो प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव सीन दी व्हाट इज स्टिरलिंग इंजन सिस्टम एंड हीलियोस्टैट। In heliostat, the Stirling engine system is majorly used for the generation of electricity. And even in parabolic dish also we are using the Stirling engine system. Heliostat, two types of engine systems are used for generation of electricity. One is nothing but Rankine cycle is used, another one is a Stirling engine is used. Especially in parabolic dish concentrating solar collector system, Stirling engine is used. This is nothing but the Stirling engine setup control system PCU, and this is receiver and this is the concentrator where the mirrors are kept as like this. It's a tracking system. So whenever the sun rays falls onto this point, that will be received by this receiver. There is a temperature variation in the disk. The shaft is rotated, the piston is moving, the piston is moved, so the shaft will be rotated. So the major parts of the parabolic dish Stirling engines are solar dish concentrator, power conversion unit and tracking system. The parabolic dish system that generates the electricity from the central power converter. So it will generate the electricity from the central power converter, which collects the absorbed sunlight from the individual receiver and deliver it via heat transfer fluid to the power conversion. So here some heat fluid will be used. So the solar energy is converted into heat energy and the steam is passed through the turbine to rotate and generate the electricity. The need to circulate heat transfer fluid throughout the collector field raises design. That means piping layout, pumping requirement, because you want to pass the fluid in the sense pumping is required, motor is required. Sometimes thermal losses will be there in the solar dish concentrator. Next to part is nothing but power conversion unit, which includes the thermal receiver and the heat engine. So thermal receiver absorbs the concentrated beam of solar energy and converts into heat. Again, that heat will be transferred to the heat engine. So heat engine, which has the piston, which has the shaft, based upon in the piston is fixed in the chamber, based upon the temperature in the chamber, the piston will be moved. According to the piston movement, the shaft will be rotated and the shaft is connected to the generator, then generator will produce the electricity. So heat transfer medium usually employed as the working fluid for an engine is either hydrogen or helium will be used. Alternate thermal receivers are heat pipes where the boiling and condensing of the intermediate fluid are used to transfer the heat to the engine. So heat engine system takes the heat from the thermal receiver, which will produce the electricity. The heat generators, which has several components, receiver to absorb the concentrated sunlight to heat the working fluid of the engine. Then again it will be converted into thermal energy, then thermal energy is converted into mechanical energy, and alternator is attached to the engine to convert the mechanical energy into electricity. So waste heat exhaust system to vent excess heat to the atmosphere, and the control system to match the engine operation to available solar energy. The distributed parabolic dish system, which has the storage capability is less. It can be hybridized to run with the fossil fuel during the periods when the sun rays is not available, during night days, night times, or cloudy times, rainy times. There we can use the some fossil fuel in order to generate the, in order to convert the water into steam. The Stirling engine is the most common type of the heat engine which is used in the dish engine system. The third one is a tracking system. The parabolic dish system, which uses the computer to track the sun and concentrate the sun rays onto the receiver located at the focal point. We are using the Stirling engine system, which is linked to the receiver to generate the electricity. So parabolic dish will generate 1000 degrees Celsius, where aerostat will generate 2000 degrees Celsius at the receiver. But here the efficiency is very high for the conversion of solar energy into electricity. But the power capacity ratio is very small. So here, this is nothing but the solar electric generation scheme. This is nothing but the working function of the working principle of the Stirling engine or Brayton heat engine. We have a collector. The collector, which is used to collect the sun rays, that will be converted into the thermal energy, and the thermal energy is stored in the thermal tank. Then it is passed on to the turbine. Turbine will rotate and generate the electricity. The same steam will be converted into water in the condenser. Then again the same thing will be passed to the steam generator, where the steam generator will convert the water into, or the steam generator will allow the water to flow through this solar collector. During no sun days or not shining days, those times the natural fuels are used to boil the boiler water, and the steam will be passed to the turbine in order to generate the electricity. After the array of mirror focus the sunlight, the concentrating light then heats up the working fluid to the temperature around 750 degree within the receiver. The heated high temperature working fluid is used either in Stirling heat engine system or Brayton heat engine system in order to produce the mechanical power via rotational kinetic energy, and then electricity for the utility use with the electric generators. In this cycle, the concentrated sunlight is focused onto the solar flare. So concentrated sunlight focuses onto the solar flare, which heats up the compressed working fluid of the cycle. Air is replacing, either lowering the amount of fuel which is needed to heat up the air in the combustion chamber for the generation of power. As I said that, based assumption made, this is a chamber. Inside the piston will be there. Based upon the piston is always located in the middle of the chamber. Based upon the temperature, the compression and expansion is taking place in the chamber. That means if the temperature is very high, then it will move to this part. If it is very low, it will come to down. So expansion and compression will be taking place. Due to the expansion and compression of the disc, the disc movement, the shaft is rotated, which is nothing but Stirling engine is rotated. The piston will be makes the engine to rotate, that means shaft to rotate. So the solar energy is converted into heat energy, heat energy is converted into mechanical energy, and mechanical energy is converted into electric energy if it is connected to the alternator. And next one is solar collector system into building services. We know that the operating cost of the solar energy conversion is very low. Initial cost of purchasing and installing the system is very high when compared to if you are using the fossil fuels. Other conventional energy system also. So we can use the solar energy whenever we want to invest more in the conventional sources, in the sense that time we can go with this solar energy system. Because availability of the solar energy is abundant, enormous and unpredictable, and no cost. It is nature resources. And it will not be decayed at any cost. Suppose if we are using fossil fuel in the sense it may be a coal or it may be oil or it may be some kind of fossil fuel gas, in the sense after a decade, after a 2 decade or 3 decade, the natural resources which is obtained from the earth will be demolished. But if you are using water also, it will be got over. But sun energy will not be, never. That is abundant, enormous energy. So we can use for this some kind of application in order to go heat the building, or to use the water retention process, or to store the heat for some kind of operations. So here we are going to see the solar hair heating system, how the solar is used for the hair heating system for the room or the building. So the most economical way we have to obtain all the energy, in the sense solar energy, in the sense the solar system will meet the basic energy demand while operating at full capacity. We can have the auxiliary system or backup system to carry the peak load and unusual loads. The main components of the building heating systems are air handling unit, heat storage unit, temperature control system and solar collectors. So this is nothing but the schematic diagram for solar air heating system. So we are using heating the building as like your AC, air conditioner. There in air conditioner, heat air is absorbed and cooling air is outleted from the air conditioner. Here the cooling air is absorbed and heat air will be passed through the building with the help of solar collector system. So we are using, there are four parts of this building. One is air handling unit. In air handling unit, we are using the fan and motor driven dampers. This is nothing but fan and dampers. Dampers is also called as a motors or sometimes blowers. Heat storage unit, rock bed heat storage unit. This is nothing but heat storage unit. This is heat storage unit. Temperature control unit. Here this is nothing but temperature control unit. And this is solar collector. So this is solar collector. So the energy will be collected here and it will be given to this tank. Here the water will be, which is circulated through the solar collector, is converted into steam. That steam air will be, hot air will be connected. That hot air will be stored here, and the cold water will be passed through this tank. That will be converted into hot water. That hot water will be given to the fan. The fan will blow the air. That air is converted into hot. That will be given to the building. So depending upon the positions of the dampers which is used here, A and B, the three modes of system operations can be achieved. What are the three modes? In the sense, damper will be the position A damper and position B damper is open. what will happen? If A is open and B is closed, that is the second mode. If A is closed and B is open, then this is the third mode. There are three modes of system operation. First condition, when A is open and B is open, both are open. This dampers or two motor driven dampers are open. What will happen in the sense? This is the normal daytime solar heating mode. So storage unit is bypassed. If the temperature sensor in the top of the collector array, this is a temperature sensor here, top of the collector array, is below necessary limit requires for the space heating. If more than the temperature which is required for space heating is obtained, that will be stored in the storage tank. So auxiliary furnace is automatically turned on and it will store the tank, the storage, thermal energy. Damper A is open, damper B is closed, in the sense, in this mode, whenever the solar heat is collected but no space heating is required at the same time, in the sense, this method is used. The fan blows the solar heated air through the rock bed and for the thermal storage. And damper A is closed and B is open, in that situation where this point is used, in the sense, during cloudy times or during night times, this mode of operation will be exist. The return air from the building, so the return air from the building is cold air now pulled to the rock bed. Now this cold air become the hot air, and again that will be picked up by the solar heat, and the auxiliary furnace is activated automatically. If the temperature is insufficient, then the fan will rotate. The fan will blow this air into the building. This is nothing but third mode of operation.